What is up, guys? This is the Average Johnny coming back to you with yet another Average video, and today we've got some official Destroy All Humans remake footage and details coming to you. And for all you fans out there, you may be pleased with what you're about to hear. So as I give out the good details, I will let you guys watch the gameplay, and if you want to hear the commentary from the director of production himself, I will leave a link down below to the video from E3. But as you can see from the gameplay footage that I'm showing you right now, we can already see that this game still looks pretty cartoony, which in my honest opinion, I really like. It stays pretty faithful to the original game, so honestly, I'm okay with that. Although there are some notable weird looking models that we see in this game. However, this is the pre-alpha version, so we shouldn't be too get carried away with that as of right now. But let's just get down to what I know about the game up to today. Something that was being reported by comicbook.com and now by the director himself, it is just the basic idea that THQ Nordic plans to stay loyal to the original game, so you shouldn't expect any major changes that would affect the game in a negative way. The game is basically just being built from scratch, but with the original premise and idea still remaining in place. However, they are planning to make changes to the gameplay itself, in which they actually just take features from the second game and they implement it into this new remake. An example is seen in this footage, in which you can clearly see that you have full control of the saucer, in which it can now levitate up and down, and it is something that was not doable in the original game. So it actually is kind of nice to see how we can get the expansive features that we had in the second game and just have them implemented into this new remake. So that is something to a positive thing to take note of. Other notable features include the help indicators that no longer take up the entire screen like in the original. So that will be very helpful to have in this game, since you won't be interrupted every time, like every 5 seconds that you're playing the game. Another thing that was mentioned is that the video game will be released in early 2020. So don't believe Amazon when they say that the game will be released in December of 2020, because that is just way too far out and none of us want that. Now, something that people have been expressing their concern about is the voice actors. Now, I am here to let you all know that yes, we will still hear the same voice actors for the game. We will still hear Invader Zim and Billy from Billy and Mandy playing the role of Pox, and Crypto will still keep his original voice actor as well. They actually reveal that they will be taking audio from the original game and just kind of making it sound a little better just for the new remake. However, there is still nothing known about new dialogue being recorded as of today, so that is still up in the air as of right now. Now let's talk about the most interesting piece that I've come upon so far. According to sources, it is possible that they will be adding even more content into the game. Comicbook.com reported that in an interview, the director of Black Forest Games stated that instead of 10 to 20 hours of gameplay that we had in the original game, we can expect to see it expanded into 30 to 40 hours, which is very exciting to hear. However, it does make me question how they plan to do that if no new voice lines are going to be recorded. We'll just have to see how that plays out. But on a final note, I will also mention that as of right now, there are no plans to implement a multiplayer, which may be a bit of a letdown, but nonetheless, it is still very exciting to see this game being remade and expanded on even more than the original. I'm pretty sure that we will have more exciting news coming to us soon. But that is all I have for you guys today. Let me know what you guys think of the footage and the details down below. And if any further news does come about, I will be informing you guys on that as well. If you found this video informative, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to stay up to date on the news of this remake that so far seems very promising. I hope you guys will have a great day, and I will be seeing you guys in the next one.